Now it's time.
Okay. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pucharine Nirvishesha Sanyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vancha Kaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhai Vacha Patitanam Pavane Vyo Vaishnavi Vyo Namo Namaha Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Gaura Chandra Jaya Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vinda
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vinda
So we're telling the pastimes of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as described in the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. And we were hearing how Lord Chaitanya departed from Jagannath Puri to go on a tour of South India. Sometimes devotees, we also go to South India. From Jagannath Puri, you can get the train down to Tirupati. From Tirupati, then it's very close to Chennai, and from Chennai you can go further south.
然后呢, 因为 Tirupati 离Chennai就很近了, 然后从 Chennai这地方呢, 可以继续南行。
So, Lord Chaitanya was walking. There were no trains, of course, 500 years ago. Lord Chaitanya was visiting all the temples on the way.
那么在500年以前呢是没有火车的, 所以说Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢他是一路步行, 他在这沿途中呢还会参拜沿途的所有的庙宇。
So we heard how he went to Kurmakshetra, and then from Kurmakshetra he came to Vishakhapatna. And saw Lord Nrisimha Dev deity there in Vishakhapatna. And then he went to he went down to the Godavari River to place on the Godavari River, and he met Ramananda Rai.
然后呢，他又去到了Godavari河，然后在Godavari河这地方呢，他就见到了Ramananda Rai.
There's a Gaudiya Math temple established at the place where Lord Chaitanya met with Ramananda Rai.
然后在这个地方呢，有一个Gaudiya Math的庙宇。
The temple was established by Om Vishnupad Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Prabhupada.
Temple has been built up by.
It was established. It was established by Om Vishnupad Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati. Prabhupada.
OK，那么这个庙宇呢，它就是由 Om Vishnupad Bhaktisanda Swami Prabhupada 所建造的。
Krishna. And just opposite, on the other side of the Godavari, at that place, we have an ISKCON temple now.
然后呢，现在是在 Godavari 河的对面呢，现在有一座 ISKCON 的庙。
So, if you like to go traveling in South India, you can go around the ISKCON temples and see many of the holy places visited by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
对呢，如果我们要是去南印度的话呢，我们就可以以这个伊斯兰庙为中心，然后看到很多 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 曾经所朝拜的圣地。
So Ramananda Rai was a very senior official in the service of the king of Jagannath Puri.
Ramananda Rai 呢，他是在Jagannath Puri 的庙的国王的一位很显赫的代表的政府官员。
So the king had sent Ramananda Rai to the southern region of the kingdom ruled by the king of Puri, and he was overseeing the affairs there.
那这个国王呢，他就南巡到这个南印度这边去巡视，在南部王国的各方面的这些国家的事宜。
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had told Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it's very important to meet him, that he's a very, very special devotee.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 曾经告诉 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，说 Ramananda Roy 是一位很特别的奉献者，所以说呢，要见到他是一件很重要的事情。
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya previously had laughed at Ramananda Rai because he thought he's just a sentimental Vaishnava.
但是 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他曾经笑话过 Ramananda Rai， 他说你只不过是一位感情用事的 Vaishnava 而已。
But after Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya met Lord Chaitanya and became also a Vaishnava, then he understood how Ramananda Rai was a very advanced devotee.
但是呢，当 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 遇到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 然后自己也变成了一位 Vaishnava 之后，他就明白了 Ramananda Rai 他是一位多么崇高的 Vaishnava 奉献者。
The Acharyas revealed to us that Ramananda Rai in Krishna Lila is the Gopi Vishakha.
Acharya 们向我们揭示说呢 ，Ramananda Rai 他在 Krishna 的逍遥时光中是 Vishakha Gopi。
Vishakha is a very dear friend of Srimati Radharani.
而 Vishakha 呢是 Srimati Radharani 的一位很亲密的好朋友。
And Lord Chaitanya is trying to cultivate the mood of Srimati Radharani.
而 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他试图要培养出 Srimati Radharani 所具备的那种心态。
In the spiritual world, there is Goloka Vrindavan, and there are Vaikuntha planets.
在灵性世界呢，有 Goloka Vrindavan， 还有 Vaikuntha 的星宿。
Now to enter into Goloka Vrindavan, you have to have a special qualification, different from Vaikuntha.
但是如果想进入 Goloka Vrindavan 的话呢，就必须要有一种特别的资质。那么这种资质呢，和 Vaikuntha 的所具备的资质是不一样的。
To go to Vaikuntha, you can have a relationship with Krishna, either in neutrality, or servant, or friend, or parent, or conjugal love.
To go to Vaikuntha or go to...
Go to Vaikuntha.
如果要是去到 Vaikuntha 的话呢，那么你可以和 Krishna 之间所处在的这种关系是，要不然就中性的关系，要不然就是仆人的关系，要不然就是朋友的关系，或者是父母之爱的关系，或者是情侣之爱的关系。
And the people, the devotees who go to Vrindavan, they practice what is called Vaidhi Bhakti, which means they follow the rules and regulations.
那但是要去到狗温的这个格洛克文大本的奉献者呢，他们会修习的是 Vaidhi Bhakti， 也就是说呢，他们会遵循这些规范和原则。
But to go to into Goloka, you have to come to the platform of spontaneous devotional service, what is called Raga Bhakti.
那刚才是去到外昆塔，但如果要是去到 Goloka 呢，那你就必须是要具备这种非常自发的要服务的这种心态，被称为叫 Raga Bhakti。
So these things were appreciated by advanced devotees like Ramananda Rai and Lord Chaitanya.
那么对这些事情呢，都是被像 Ramananda Rai 或者 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这样非常高深精进的奉献者所欣赏着。
So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj has given us some of the main topics which Lord Chaitanya and Ramananda Rai discussed with each other.
所以说呢，在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 永恒的 Chaitanya 经里呢， Krishna Das Kaviraj Maharaj 呢就为我们揭示了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Roy 之间的探讨的话题的一些内容。
It is said that the activities of Lord Chaitanya can be compared to condensed milk.
是这样说的， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的活动呢可以被比喻成是炼乳。
And the activities of Ramananda Rai are like lumps of sugar candy.
Ramananda Rai 他的这个活动呢，就好像是一根甘蔗。
Sugar candy.
Ganja.
Ganja. Oh, okay.
Ganja.
Sugar candy. Ganja 糖。
甘蔗糖 candy sugar， 那就是甘蔗糖，由甘蔗做的糖。
And then, when Ramananda Rai and Lord Chaitanya discuss topics of Radha and Krishna, then it is like adding camphor into the mixture of condensed milk and sugar candy.
那么当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Rai 在谈话的时候呢，就好像是把樟脑给加进了炼乳以及这个蔗糖之中。
So the taste is very delicious.
那这样一来呢，就让这个味道变得非常的鲜美。
Of course, I know you Chinese people, you don't much like sweet things.
但是我知道咱中国人呢，可能不是特别的喜欢吃甜品。
But Indian people, they very much like sweet.
但是呢，印度人可喜欢吃甜品了。
So when you have condensed milk mixed with sugar candy and add the camphor, oh, it's very, very tasty.
所以说呢，当把炼乳以及蔗糖还有樟脑给加在一起的时候，哎呀，这个味道实在是太美味了。
So this is what happens when Ramananda Rai and Lord Chaitanya are discussing topics of Radha and Krishna.
所以说呢，这也就是当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Roy 他们之间在探讨关于 Sri Radha 和 Krishna 的话题的时候所发生的结果。
So Ramananda Roy is especially qualified to be able to discuss these things.
但是呢 ，Ramananda Roy 呢，他是特别的具有资格能够探讨这样的话题。
But when he speaks, he always gives the credit to Lord Chaitanya.
但是呢，当他在讲话的时候呢，他总是把这个功劳归咎于主 Chaitanya。
And he would say, "I don't know anything about topics of Krishna. I simply speak because you make some sounds. You vibrate the sound that comes out from me."
会说呢，其实我对于关于 Sri Krishna 的话题是一无所知的。我之所以能够讲的原因呢，是由于您。发出了这样震动的声音，然后呢，这个声音从我的身体里面传了出来。
I'm just your parrot. Whatever instructions you give me, I repeat.
我只不过是您的鹦鹉而已，无论您给我怎样的训示，我只不过是把它重复出来而已。
You inspire me from the heart.
是您在内心中激励着我。
I don't know if I'm speaking good or bad.
所以我对于我到底讲的是好啊还是不好啊，我根本就不知道。
But then Lord Chaitanya says, well, I don't know anything. I'm a Mayavadi sannyasi.
但是 Chaitanya 妈妈不说呢，哎，我可什么都不懂，我只不过就是一个 Mayavadi 的 sannyasi 而已。
What can I understand about pastimes of Radha and Krishna? I only know Mayavadi philosophy.
我怎么能够理解 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光呢？我唯一了解的是 Mayavadi 的哲学。
And then Lord Chaitanya says,Because I had association with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, I have become enlightened a little.
但是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，就是由于我和 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的联谊，使得我得到了那么一点点的启发。
And when I asked Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya about loving service to Krishna, he told me, he said, go and see Ramananda Roy, he knows.
那么当我问 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 关于对 Krishna 的服务的时候，他对我说，你要去见Ramananda Roy, 他知道关于这方面的信息。
So Lord Chaitanya said, this is why I've come here. I've come here to hear from you.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，这就是为什么会来到这里，我来到这里就是为了听你讲述的。
You're just respecting me because I'm a sannyasi, that's only material.
那你之所以这么的尊敬我的原因呢，是由于我是一位 sannyasi, 可这是物质的。
And then Lord Chaitanya gave very special instruction, which is very well known by devotees.
然后呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就给出了很特别的训示。那么这个训示呢，在奉献者中间呢，是非常的被家喻户晓的。
Kiba vipra kiba nasi sudra keni nai.Ye Krishna Tadvivet Se Guru Hoy. The meaning is, what does not matter if you're a Brahmana or a Sannyasi or a Sudra. Whatever position you're in, you can become a Guru if you know the science of Krishna.
无论你是一位 Sannyasi, 婆罗门 Sudra, 还是Sudra 还是 Vaishya,那么只要你知道关于 Krishna 的科学，那么你就可以成为一名 Guru, 成为一名灵性导师。
Somebody wants to initiate disciples, they have to be conversant with the philosophy of Krishna consciousness.
那么如果一个人他想要去启迪门徒的话呢，他就必须要非常的熟知关于 Krishna 知觉的知识。
They should study Bhakti Shastri, and after Bhakti Shastri, they should study Bhakti Vaibhav.
首先呢，他们要研习 Bhakti Shastri 风来经典，在这之后呢，还要学习 Bhakti Vaibhav.
Then Bhakti Vedanta.
然后是 Bhakti Vedanta.
Then Bhakti Sarvabhauma.
然后呢是 Bhakti Sarvabhauma.
The idea is, we have to study.The books written by Srila Prabhupada.
那这个概念呢，就是说我们必须要研习由 Srila Prabhupada 所著写的书籍。
If we don't read Prabhupada's books, then you may get very confused about the philosophy.
因为如果我们要是不研习 Srila Prabhupada 的书籍的话，我们可能就会对这个哲学感到很困惑。
And if you're reading the books regularly,then it should not be difficult for you to take these courses.
但是如果我们要是有规律的去阅读书籍的话，那么我们去也学习所有的这些课程也就不难了。
Now, many devotees in China are also taking Bhakti Shastri. That's very good.
那现在在中国有很多奉献者都在学习风爱经典的课程，这非常的好。
Bhakti Shastri is the first step inAnd generally, people who want to get second initiation, they should have completed the Bhakti Shastri course.
那 Bhakti Shastri 的课程呢，是我们要学习的所有的课程的第一步。那通常来说，想要得到二次启迪的奉献者，他是需要完成 Bhakti Shastri 的课程的。
If you haven't studied the Bhakti Shastri, then what is you don't have any qualification for the second initiation.
如果要是我们还没有开始学习 Bhakti Sastri 的课程的话，那也就意味着我们根本就不具备获得二次启迪的资格了。
Some devotees think, oh, I've been here 5 years, so I should get second initiation.
那有些奉献者说，哦，我都已经在这儿5年了，所以呢，我应该得到二次启迪。
But we want to see what you know. What have you learned?
但是我们希望能够看到您都已经了解了哪些知识，都已经学到了些什么。
Once you've said you've been coming for 5 years to associate with devotees, so you must have learned something. So you should be able to speak.
那么既然您已经和奉献者联谊了5年，那也就意味着您应该是学习到了一些信息，那你也应该可以因为学到了一些信息而讲述了。
If you're not going to speak, then you have to do the puja, you have to offer the arti, you have to do the brahminical work, either on the altar serving the deity or in the kitchen cooking.
但是如果要是不讲课的话呢，那么就至少要去从事婆罗门所从事的这个服务，也就是说呢，要进行arti，要崇拜神像，或者是在神坛上崇拜神像，或者是在厨房里去进行烹制做饭这样的服务。
The second initiation is given so that you can do more service.
而且呢，你得到这个启迪之后呢，这样你就可以去做更多的服务。
Some people think now I'm second initiated, I should sit back and do nothing.
有些人觉得我现在已经二次启迪了，所以呢，我就要在后边坐着歇着了。
No, this is not correct. Second initiation means we do more service.
那这是不对的。那二次启迪也就意味着我们应该要去从事更多的服务。
So Lord Chaitanya told Ramananda Rai, he said, don't think I'm a learned sannyasi. I don't know anything.
对，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Ramananda Rai 说呢，你别觉得我好像什么都懂。我什么都不懂。
I just want you to tell me about Radha and Krishna.
我只是想让你告诉我关于 Radha 和 Krishna 的信息。
So hearing these words from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Ramananda Rai was a little disturbed. He said, "I am just like a puppet."
所以听了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这一席话之后呢？使得Ramananda Roy 的内心呢有一些被打扰。他说呢，我只不过是一个木偶而已。
You're controlling me. You're pulling the strings.
是您在控制着我，是您在牵着我手上，就是我牵着我的那个线。
My tongue is just like a stringed instrument, and you are the player.
那我的这个舌头呢，只不过是一个带弦的乐器而已，而您是拨动这个弦乐的音乐人。
So whatever I say, it's coming because of you, from your instructions.
那所以说，无论我说出了什么，全部都是因为您所给我的指导，所以我才说出来的。
So Ramananda Rai begins to speak about Krishna. He says, Krishna is the source of everything. All the incarnations, they all come from Krishna.
然后呢 ，Ramananda Rai 他就开始讲述关于 Krishna 的话题了。他说呢，这个Krishna 讲述 Krishna 所有的这些化身，他是源泉，所有的一切全部都来自于 Krishna 的。
There's an infinite number of incarnations.
而且呢 ，Sri Krishna 的化身呢是无限多的。
And there's an infinite number of Vaikuntha planets in the spiritual world.
而且在灵性世界的 Vaikuntha 星宿的数量也是无限多的。
And in the material world, there's also an infinite number of universes.
而在这物质世界呢，宇宙的数量也是无限多的。
And Krishna is the resting place of everything.
而 Krishna 呢，它是一切的栖息之所。
Krishna's body is full of eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
而 Krishna 的躯体呢是永恒、极乐以及充满知识的。
And he is the son of Nanda Maharaj.
他呢是 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子。
So Ramananda Rai, this describes how in the spiritual world, Krishna is worshipped by chanting the Gayatri Mantra.
Ramananda Roy 又描述着在灵性世界 Sri Krishna 他如何是通过念诵 Gayatri Mantra 而被崇拜着。
Right, Krishna, in the spiritual world, we have to know how to worship him properly.
所以说呢，在灵性世界，我们必须要知道如何能够恰当的去崇拜 Sri Krishna。
So when we chant the mantras, we have to chant with pure love and devotion.
所以呢，当我们在念诵盖春曼陀罗的时候，我们应该是怀着纯粹的爱以及奉爱之情去念诵的。
We should know that Krishna attracts everyone, male and female, moving and not moving.
而且我们也知道 Krishna 他是吸引所有人的，无论是男人还是女人，无论是动的与不动的一切的生物体。
To worship Krishna is a very special opportunity given to fortunate living entities.
那么对于崇拜 Krishna 呢对于所有的这些生物体来说都是一个非常幸运的很特别的机会。
We were hearing about Krishna's pastimes with his devotees in the spiritual world, how he was in Goloka Vrindavan, he's dancing the Rasa Lila with the gopis.
那我们也听到了在灵性世界在灵性世界，在 Vrindavan， Sri Krishna 和他的奉献者如何进行他们的逍遥时光，以及在 Goloka Vrindavan， Krishna 和 Gopi 们一起上演 Rasa Lila 的逍遥。
So each and every devotee, each and every Gopi was thinking they're dancing with Krishna.
那在 Rasa 之舞的时候呢，每一位 Gopi 都觉得他是在和 Krishna 在单独跳舞。
Each and every devotee has a relationship, a personal relationship with Krishna.
所以呢，每一位奉献者都和 Krishna 有他们自己个人和 Krishna 之间的关系。
And Krishna is the object; he's the worshipable Lord for everyone.
所以 Krishna 他是这个对象，他是对于每一个人来说都是要去崇拜和爱的对象。
So there's a very special mood between all the gopis and Srimati Radharani.
那么所有的 gopi 和 Srimati Radharani 之间呢有一种特别的心绪。
That all the gopis, they feel great pleasure when Radharani is with Krishna. They're very happy to see Krishna with Radharani.
当 Srimati Radharani 和 Krishna 在一起的时候呢，所有的这些 Gopi 们都非常的开心，看到他们在一起。
But Radharani, she likes to see Krishna with the Gopis, and she likes to give the Gopis a chance to be with Krishna, and she feels pleasure when she sees the Gopis with Krishna.
而 Srimati Radharani 呢，她也希望能够为Gopi 们营造这样的机会，能够看到Gopi 们和 Sri Krishna 在一起。所以呢，当他看到 Gopi 们和 Krishna 在一起的时候，他也非常的开心。
This and Krishna feels pleasure also seeing the Gopis and Radharani how they have this mood that they want to please each other.
那 Krishna 当他看到了 Srimati Radharani 和这些 Gopi 们他们彼此之间相亲相爱相互取悦的这种氛围的时候呢，他也很开心。
So Krishna is so attractive that he attracts all the goddesses of fortune who are actually, they're the consorts of Lord Narayan, but they also become attracted to Krishna.
那 Krishna 呢，他是非常的具有吸引力的，那他呢吸引了所有的这一些幸运女神们。那么在 Vaikuntha 星宿呢，所有这些幸运女神都是 主 Narayana 的妻子，但是呢，她们也被 Krishna 所吸引。
And not only are the goddesses of fortune attracted to Krishna, but Lord Mahavishnu is attracted to see Krishna.
不仅仅是幸运女神们被 Krishna 所吸引，就连 Mahavishnu 也被 Krishna 所吸引。
This is described by that pastime which comes in the 10th canto in relation to the Brahmana in Dwarka, whose wife had given birth to sons, but each son at the time of birth was there was a miscarriage.
那这个这段消息光就是这个故事呢是被描述在圣殿波迦瓦坛第十篇的一个消息光里。那这消息光呢讲的是婆罗门的妻子们，他们就是怀上了孩子，但是呢每次当他们怀了孩子以后呢都会流产。
So the Brahmana came to complain to the palace, to the ruler's palace in Dwarka.
所以呢，这个婆罗门呢就来到了多尔卡的皇宫，向这儿的统治者进行抱怨。
I said, "You're not protecting my wife. She's giving birth to children, and they're all dying." So he blamed the king.
然后他就在指责这国王，说呢，你为什么不保护我的妻子？我的妻子在每次怀孕，可是每次怀孕，这孩子全都流产而夭折了。So
Arjuna happened to be there at the time, and he heard the Brahmana criticize the Kshatriya king. So Arjuna said, "If your wife gives birth again, I will protect her."
那当时呢，Arjuna恰巧在，然后Arjuna就听到了婆罗门在斥责刹帝利的国王，所以Arjuna就说，那下次等你的妻子再怀孕的时候呢，我亲自保护她。So
when the Brahmana's wife was ready to deliver another child, Arjuna was guarding and he was trying to be there and to protect the Brahmana's wife and make sure the child's birth was proper.
那所以说，等这次这位婆罗门的妻子要准备生产的时候呢，Arjuna就来到他的身边，然后呢，准备要保护这位婆罗门的妻子，然后以确保这个孩子能够安全的生下来。Arjuna
had vowed that if he could not protect the child, he would give up his life.
那当时Arjuna他发了誓，他说如果要是他保护不了这孩子的生命的话，那他就要自杀。So
when the Brahmin's wife was delivering her child, again the child miscarriage.
但是呢，这次当婆罗门的妻子再次生产的时候呢，这孩子又夭折了。So
the Brahmana came to Arjuna and said, "See, so much for your protection. You're hopeless. You're useless. You should give up your life."
然后这位婆罗门就来到Arjuna的面前，你瞧瞧，您给我的这个保护能起多大作用呢？您简直太无用了，您现在还是自行了断您的生命吧。
So Krishna happened to be there and told Arjuna, he said, "Don't give up your life yet." He said, "You come with me, we'll go and find the children, what happened to them."
但是当时呢，Krishna正好在，Krishna就对Arjuna说呢，你先稍微等一等，你先别放弃你的生命呢。 我现在要带你去看所有的这些孩子，看看这些孩子都发生了一些什么事情。So
Krishna went with Arjuna on his chariot, and they went right out through the covering of the universe, and they went into the abode of liberation.
那然后呢，Arjuna 和 Krishna 他们就一起坐上了战车，并且呢，他们来到了这个宇宙的，就是覆盖宇宙的这一层，并且来到了解脱的居所。
And there, Lord Mahavishnu is laying in the causal ocean.
在那里呢，Mahavishnu他躺在原因之阳里。
And they saw that Lord Mahavishnu was there, and he had all the children of the Brahmana. They were also there with Lord Mahavishnu.
那他们在那儿就见到了主Mahavishnu，并且呢，看到了这位婆罗门所有的夭折的这些孩子，全部都和Mahavishnu在一起。
So Lord Krishna and Arjuna went to see Lord Mahavishnu, and Lord Mahavishnu worshipped them, and he thanked them for coming to see him.
然后Arjuna和Krishna呢就来拜见Mahavishnu，然后Mahavishnu呢就崇拜了他们，并且感谢他们来拜访他。And
Lord Mahavishnu explained, he said, I stole all the Brahmana's children because I wanted you and Arjuna to come and see me. I wanted to see both of you."
然后呢，Mahavishnu说呢，我把这婆罗门的所有的孩子都给偷走了。的原因呢，就是因为我希望你们俩能够来看我。Arjuna和Krishna，你们俩能一起来看我。
So this shows how how attractive Lord Krishna is that even Lord Mahavishnu wants to see Krishna.
那所以在这里面呢，就展示了 Krishna 他是多么具有吸引力，就连 Mahavishnu 都想要见到 Sri Krishna， 都被 Krishna 所吸引。
And we see how the goddess of fortune, she desires to get association with Krishna.
而且呢，我们也看到了幸运女神，她如何渴望着想要得到 Sri Krishna 的联谊。
There's a prayer by, there's a prayer in the tenth. There's a prayer in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam which is given by the wives of the Kaliya serpent, the Nagapatnis. They're called the Nagapatnis, the wives of the Kaliya snake.
那么在圣典波迦瓦坛第十篇里面呢，有一个祷文，这祷文呢是由卡利亚的妻子 Nagapatni 所给出的。
We know how Lord Krishna had danced on the heads of the Kaliya serpent.
我们大家都知道主 Krishna 他如何在卡利亚蛇的头上跳舞。
So the goddess, the wives of the Kaliya snake, they offered prayers to Krishna.
所以呢，这个蛇的妻子们，就向 Sri Krishna 献上了祷文。
And they said, "We don't know how our husband could be so fortunate that he could be touched by your lotus feet."
他们说到呢，我们不知道我们的丈夫能够如此的幸运，能够被您的莲花足所触碰他的头。
And they said the goddess of fortune, she did austerities for hundreds of years trying to get this opportunity.
然后他们就讲到了幸运女神，他们为了想要得到这样的机会，曾经进行了几百万这个成千上万年的苦行。
But she didn't get it.Although she did a lot of austerity and she had a strong desire, but she couldn't get the mercy of Krishna. She couldn't get the dust from his feet.
那虽然说她做了这么多的苦行，而且还有强烈的愿望，但是呢，她却没有办法得到 Krishna 这样的仁慈，她没有办法得到 Sri Krishna 莲花足上的尘土。
But somehow our husband, this Kaliya snake, he got the mercy of Krishna.
但是呢，不知怎的。卡利亚的蛇，他就是这些那个 party 的妻子的丈夫，就得到了这样的仁慈。
And Lord Krishna is so attractive that he attracts himself.
Sri Krishna 他如此的具有吸引力，他把自己也吸引着。
One time when he was in the palace in Dwarka, he saw his own reflection, and he wondered, "Oh, who is this person? What a wonderful person!"
那有一次呢，他在 Dwarka 的宫殿中看到了自己的这个影子，然后呢，他就说：“哎呀，这个人实在太美了，这个人是谁啊？他太有吸引力了。”
It was his own reflection, but he was saying, "Oh, I'm so eager to embrace this person."
然后他看到的是他自己的这个折射的影子，然后呢，他就说：“哎呀，这个人实在太有吸引力了，我实在想抱抱他。”
So this is.How Ramananda Rai explained about Lord Krishna, and then he's going to explain about Radharani.
So, this is Ramananda Rai. He's talking about Krishna. Now, he's going to explain Srimati Radharani.
He explains about Lord Krishna has three energies. There's the spiritual energy, the material energy, and the marginal energy.
他解释说呢 ，Sri Krishna 具有三种能量，它们分别是灵性能量、物质能量和边际能量。
Lord Vishnu is the spiritual energy, and living entities are meant to be also the spiritual energy.
那主 Krishna 呢？它是灵性的能量，而这生物体呢？它本来也应该是，处在的是灵性能量中的。
And then there are three potencies in the spiritual world.
在灵性世界呢，有三种力量。
There's the Ladini Shakti, or the potency of bliss.
其中呢是有一个是 Ladini Shakti， 也就是极乐的能量。
Then there's the Sandini potency, which is for eternal existence, to maintain everything.
然后呢是 Sandini 能量。那么这 Sandini 能量呢，它是表示着是永恒的存在，它在维系着一切。
And there's also the third potency is the Samvit Shakti, which is relation to knowledge, it's knowing everything.
然后第三种能量呢叫 Samvit Shakti。那它和知识有相，它是和知识相关的能量。
So the Srimati Radharani, she personifies the Ladini Shakti, the bliss potency of the Supreme Lord.
而 Srimati Radharani 她所代表的呢是 Ladini Shakti， 她是主的极乐的能量的人格化身。
And through that Ladini Shakti, Krishna enjoys spiritual pleasure.
而通过这拉丁尼沙帝 Krishna 他享受着灵性的快乐。
Krishna is happy himself, but he gets more happiness through this Ladini Shakti.
Krishna 他本来自行就是快乐的，但是他通过这拉丁尼沙帝呢变得更加的快乐。
And the main part of that Ladini Shakti is a loving relationship with the Supreme Lord.
Ladini Shakti, 它最主要的一部分呢，就是和主和至尊主之间的爱的关系。
And that loving ecstasy, this is Radharani.
而这爱的极乐呢，就是 Srimati Radharani.
So.From all the gopis, it appears Radharani is the most important.
那在所有的这些 gopi 们中呢，Srimati Radharani 她是最重要的。
She shows the highest ecstasy of love.
她所展现的是最高的关于爱的极乐。
Other gopis, they cannot compare to Radharani.
而其他的那些 gopi 呢是没有办法和 Srimati Radharani 相比拟的。
She is a friend of Krishna, and everybody knows about this.
那么 Srimati Radharani 呢，她是 Krishna 的好朋友，所有的人都知道这一点。
Radharani's body is a transformation of love of God.
Srimati Radharani 的躯体呢是对神爱的转化。
So Radharani's her only business is to satisfy Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 她唯一需要忙活的事情就是让主满意。
And all the gopis, they're all expansions of Radharani.
而所有的这些 gopi 们呢，全部都是 Srimati Radharani 的扩展。
And they all come to assist Radharani in her service to Krishna.
他们全部都是来协助 Srimati Radharani， 协助 Srimati Radharani 对于 Sri Krishna 的服务。
It is said from the time of her birth, Radharani, when she was born, she didn't open her eyes. Her eyes were closed.
有这样的说法，当 Srimati Radharani 出生的时候呢，她不睁眼，她始终让眼睛闭着。
So her mother and father, Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, they're in Varsana, and they came one day over to Gokul to see Nanda and Yashoda.
那有一次呢，Srimati Radharani 的父母亲，Vrishabhanu 王和 Kirtida 妈妈呢，他们有一天呢就到 Gokul 来拜望 Nanda Maharaj 和 Yashoda 妈妈。
No, wait, I got it wrong. It was Nanda and Yashoda came to Varsana.To see Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida.
我刚才讲错了，是这样的，就是 Nanda Maharaj 和亚瑟的妈妈，他们来到了 Vrishabhanu 王的皇宫来拜见 Vrishabhanu 王和Kirtida 妈妈。
They had heard that Maharaj Vrishabhanu had a daughter, so they brought their child Krishna to see Vrishabhanu Maharaj's daughter. And as soon as Krishna came in front of Radharani, then Radharani opened her eyes. The first person she saw was Lord Krishna. She only has love, she only had, wants to see Krishna, doesn't want to see any other man. So just see the quality of her chastity, how she is so chaste. And she is very deeply attached to Lord Krishna. When Krishna will go off to the forest in the morning, then she will feel pain of separation. Of course, all the gopis were feeling separation when Krishna would go to the forest. So her gopi friends, Radharani's gopi friends, they're also involved in the pastimes of Krishna. This way they're always thinking about association with Krishna. When Krishna goes off, they are thinking, when will he come back? So, Radharani's qualities are like a mine which is full of valuable jewels. We cannot compare the love of Radharani to any love which we know in the material world. And we see also devotees like Kubja. Now Kubja, she also had attraction for Krishna. She was very much attracted to Krishna. When Krishna came to Mathura, he had met Kubja, and Kubja had given all of her sandalwood to Krishna. And she asked Krishna to come to her house. Krishna said, "Oh, I'll come later, I have something to do first. We'll see you later." So Kubja, she also has love of Krishna, but her love is not like the love of the gopis. Because the gopis, they have pure love. So their love is compared to gold, and the love of Kubja is compared to iron.
那么，勾皮们对Krishna的爱呢，是一种非常纯粹的爱。那勾皮的爱被比喻成像是金子般的爱，可是 Kubja 对 Krishna 的爱呢，被比喻成像是铁。
So, everybody envies the gopis, and of all the gopis, the topmost gopi is Srimati Radharani.
所有的人呢都很嫉妒gopi，而这gopi中处于最高位的gopi就是Srimati Radharani。
Even the goddesses of fortune, Lakshmi and the Parvati, the wife of Lord Shiva, they want to get Radharani's beauty and her qualities.
即便是像Lakshmi幸运女神或者Parvati主Shiva的妻子， 他们也都希望能够得到Srimati Radharani的美丽以及她的品质。
And Vashishta, he has a very good chaste wife. His wife is called Arundhati.
Vashishta, 他有一位非常贞洁的妻子，他的妻子名字被称为叫Arundhati。
So, she wants to get the chastity and the religious principles of Srimati Radharani. Even Krishna cannot understand the greatness of Srimati Radharani. They're beyond his power of his understanding.
那么即便是Sri Krishna, 他都没有办法去理解Srimati Radharani所具备的这种高尚品质。那么他的这种就是 对于Srimati Radharani这种理解是超越了他自己的理解范围内的。
So in this way, Ramananda Rai was describing the qualities of Krishna and then Radharani.
所以就以这样的方式呢, Ramananda Rai他就在描述着Sri Krishna的品质, 然后呢又描述着Srimati Radharani的这些品质。
So Lord Chaitanya then says, I want to know about how they enjoy together Radha and Krishna.
然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu又说呢，我希望能够了解Radha和Krishna他们是如何相互的在一起享受的。
You've told me about their individual qualities, but what about when they're together?
你现在是告诉了我们他们分别所处在的这种品质，但是当他们在一起的时候又是怎样的呢？
So Ramananda Rai says, Krishna's business is sense gratification. He likes sense gratification.
然后 Ramananda Rai 说呢， Krishna 他要做的事儿就是感官享乐，他很喜欢感官享乐。
And he likes to control his girlfriends.
而且呢，他也喜欢去控制他那些女朋友们。
He's very expert in joking with them and give them some unnecessary anxiety.
然后呢，他非常的在行的，能够去和他们开玩笑，然后呢，还会给他们造成各种各样不必要的内心上的焦虑。
Krishna enjoys pastimes with the gopis in the forests of Vrindavan.
Krishna 他非常的享受着在文达文的森林里面和gopi们上演着逍遥。
And while he is still a young man, not very old, he was having these pastimes with, especially with Radharani.
而且呢，他还是一个年轻人，他也岁数不大，那么他就在这个文达文的森林里面，特别是和Srimati Radharani 享受着这些逍遥。
So, Ramananda Rai then tells Lord Chaitanya, there's one more topic you may like to hear.
然后呢, Ramananda Rai 对Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢, 还有一个话题, 也许您可能想要有兴趣来听。
You may like it, you may not. You may not be happy with it.
你也许可能喜欢听这个话题, 也许可能不太喜欢。
This is a topic about very intimate pastimes between Krishna and Radharani.
那么这是关于Radha和Krishna之间非常亲密的逍遥时光的话题。
And Ramananda Rai then began to sing a song which he had written.
那然后呢，Ramananda Rai呢就开始唱起了一首他所写的歌。
But when he began to sing it, then Lord Chaitanya jumped up and he put his hand over the mouth of Ramananda Rai. He didn't want him to sing.
但是呢，当Ramananda Rai一开始唱起来的时候呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu立刻就跳了起来，并且呢，把他的手一把堵住了Ramananda Rai的嘴。 他不想让他唱。
The song was about very special dealings between Krishna and the gopis.
因为呢，这首歌他所唱的呢是 Krishna 和 gopi 们之间非常特别的一些活动。
In the beginning, there's some separation, and then later on, then there's meeting.
那么在这歌最开始唱的呢是他们之间的分离。之后呢，有一些相会。
Sometimes Srimati Radharani, sometimes she's in so much ecstasy for Krishna that when she sees something black, like the tamal tree, which is a black color, she thinks it's Krishna, and she will go and embrace the tree.
那 Srimati Radharani 呢，因为她开始她对 Sri Krishna 有这么多的依恋之情，然后呢，当她看到了一些黑色的东西的时候，比如她看到了这个 tamal 树的时候，那她就觉得这是 Krishna， 所以她就想过去抱住这棵树。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he said, yeah, this is the limit, this is the goal of human life, to develop this kind of love.
对，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，这就是我们的极限，这是我们人，就是我们人类应该所制定的生活的目标，就是应该去达到这样的爱的目标。
So Lord Chaitanya asked Ramananda Roy, how can we achieve the goal?
所以呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就询问 Ramananda Roy， 我们如何能够达到这样的目标呢？
So Ramananda Roy saying, anyway, here I'm not speaking. He said, you're speaking through me, so you can hear my explanation, which is actually your explanation because you're speaking through me.
然后呢 ，Ramananda Roy 说呢，无论如何呢，其实并不是我在讲述，而是您通过我在讲述。那么所以说呢，那您可以通过我的这个讲述来聆听，但是其实这是您自己在讲述。
So the main thing is, don't hear from somebody who is not a devotee. You have to hear from someone who is a devotee. If you hear from a non-devotee, then it's very bad.
那这要点呢，就是说不要从一个非奉献者那里去聆听，必须要从一位奉献者那里去聆听。如果要是从一位非奉献者那里去聆听的话，那就是非常不好的事情。
You want to understand Radha and Krishna.You have to be in the mood of the gopis.
如果你要是想明白 Radha 和 Krishna 的话，那你必须要处于 gopi 的心态。
It's not enough if you're just a servant or a family man or a government man.
那如果你只是一个仆人，或者是一个居家的居士，或者是一个政府的官员的话，这可不够。
Only the gopis can understand these pastimes.
只有 gopi 们才能够理解这些小时光。
If we want to understand them, we have to follow in the mood of the gopis.
如果我们要是想要理解这些小时光的话，那我们就必须要追随 gopi 们的心态。
Without the help of the gopis, we cannot understand.
如果要是没有 gopi 们的帮助的话，我们是理解不了的。
So, very confidential to understand these pastimes.
所以说呢，去了解这些消时光是非常机密的。
So we have to practice living in Vrindavan by hearing about the talks of the gopis.
那所以说呢，我们就必须要休息，居住在 Vrindavan， 通过聆听关于 gopi 的这些话题，那里去休息。
But at the same time, we shouldn't think that we are a gopi.
但是与此同时呢，我们不能够认为我们自己就是 gopi 了。
So Ramananda Rai, he is explaining all of this for the pleasure of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
对，那 Ramananda Rai 呢？他为了要取悦 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，在解释着所有这一切。
We want to understand the pastimes of Radha and Krishna. We have to develop the mood of the gopis. They're the only ones. They're the only ones who can understand.
所以，如果我们要是想要了解 Radha 和 Krishna 的话题的话呢，我们就必须要培养出 gopi 们所处在这种心绪，因为他们是唯一能够了解这个话题的人。
Remember, gopis, they don't want to enjoy Krishna themselves.
我们大家一定要记得 ，gopi 们他们自己并不想去享受 Krishna.
They want to see Krishna with Radha. That's their pleasure.
他们希望能够看到的是 Radha 和 Krishna 在一起，这才是让他们感到快乐的地方。
Radharani is like the creeper. Of love of God.
Srimati Radharani, 她就好像是对于神的爱的爬藤。
And the gopis, they're like the flowers and the leaves of that creeper.
而这些 gopi 们呢，就像是在这根爬藤上的嫩叶以及鲜花。
And when we put the nectar of Krishna's pastimes on that creeper, then it increases. It becomes greater and greater.
那么当我们把 Krishna 的消食光给放在这颗爬藤上的时候呢，那么这颗爬藤它就会变得越来越茂密，越来越茁壮。
Radharani's friends, the gopis, they never want to enjoy Krishna on their own.
Radharani 的这些朋友们，这些 gopi 们，他们从来都不祈求着能够自己独自的去享受 Krishna.
And Radharani tries to get Krishna to enjoy with the gopis.
Radharani 呢，他也试图要让 Krishna 和所有的这些 gopi 们在一起，尽显快乐。
And Radharani gets more pleasure in separation from Krishna than she gets in being with Krishna.
那么当Srimati Radharani 和 Krishna 分离的时候，比他在和 Krishna 相见的时候更加让他处于喜乐之中。
When she's coming to see Krishna, or when they're separated from each other, then Radharani is intensely absorbed in Krishna.
那么当他们相见，然后之后呢又分离的时候，那这会儿 Krishna Srimati Radharani 他会让自己非常炽烈的沉醉在对 Krishna 的思念之中。
The natural desire of the gopis is to love Krishna.
那么这也是那么对于 gopi 们他们非常自然的一种愿望，就是要去爱 Krishna。
So we said there's the lust like kubja, and there's the gold like the gopis.
那所以呢，我们说呢，就有像 kubja 所展现出来的色欲，那么也有像 gopi 们所展现出来的金子。
Okay, so we'll ask, is there any questions here today?
OK, 让我们看看在今天有没有任何的问题。Yes, Maharaj, but we still have a couple of questions from yesterday.
Oh, OK, what's the questions from yesterday?
Yeah, let me see. The first question from, I think from Subhuti Raya Prabhu. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj.顶拜翻译和奉献者，以前听讲课说呢 ，Srimati Radharani 特别希望看到别的奉献者服务 Krishna， 他没有嫉妒，他甚至把奉献者带到 Krishna 的面前。但 Srimati Radharani 看到 Gopi 们和 Krishna 在一起跳舞的时候，他有点生气的离开了。 那么如何理解 Radharani 的这样的心态呢？ Please accept my verbal obeisances. From the previous lectures, I heard that Sri Mati Radharani really hope to see the other devotees to do the service for Lord Krishna, and she doesn't have any jealousy or envy, and she even bring the devotees to Lord Krishna. However, from today's lecture that Sri Mati Radharani, one, she see the gopis to dance with Lord Krishna, she showed a little bit angry and she left. So how to understand her mood from this lila?
That is, her mood like that is to give Krishna pleasure. She shows this anger and envy, doesn't like being there with all the other gopis, because she knows Krishna wants to enjoy her company without all these other gopis.
那其实Sri Mati Radharani她所处的这种心态呢，她其实是希望能够让就是其他的这些gopi 们能够和 Krishna 在一起，然后呢能让 Krishna 感到开心，因为她知道如果要是他在那儿和这个 Krishna 在一起的话呢，那 Krishna 其实是想和他在一起，而不是和其他那些 gopi 们在一起的，所以他就离开了。
She Radharani's activities, her actions are all done for the pleasure of Krishna.
那么 Sri Mati Radharani 他所从事的所有的活动，全部都是为了要让 Krishna 开心。
So her leaving the rasa dance was for Krishna's pleasure.
那所以呢，他离开这个 Rasa 之舞的舞场的原因呢，是为了让 Krishna 高兴。
So that Krishna could be with Radharani privately.
那这样呢，因为他离开了以后呢，那 Krishna 就可以和他单独在一起了。
So all of the gopis, they're all of the same mood, that their business is to give pleasure to Krishna.
那所有的这些 gopi 们呢，他们其实所处在的心态都是一样，他们其实就是为了让 Krishna 高兴。
In the presence of all the gopis, they add more variety to the pastimes. They give more pleasure. They allows more lila and more pastime pleasure.
因为有所有的这些 gopi 们在场呢，就使得这些逍遥时光呢就变得更加的有滋味，就让这个逍遥时光呢变得更加的就有更多的逍遥时光可以上演。
Without all the other gopis, if there's only Radha and Krishna, then you don't have all the pleasure, you don't have all the dealings and the you know all these pastimes taking place. You're just the two of them there.
那如果要是只有 Radha 和 Krishna 没有其他的那些逍遥时光的话，没有其他那些 gopi 们在场的话呢，那也就意味着只有他们俩，而没有其他那些事儿发生，那也就不可能有其他那些逍遥时光的这些情景发生了，那等于就没意思。
So the presence of all the other gopis adds to the pleasure and the lila, and then creates a different pastimes for the dealings between Radha and Krishna.
所以说呢，所有的这些gopi 姑娘在这儿呢，就是为了要让这个 lila 变得更加的有滋味，然后呢，使得 Radha 和 Krishna 之间的这个逍遥时光呢，也变得更加的有趣儿。
Sometimes Krishna's rejected by Radharani, and that's also to increase the pleasure of meeting Krishna again.
那有的时候呢 ，Radharani 他会拒绝 Krishna， 那其实这也是为了要让他们两人之间的再次相会变得更加的有意思。
And sometimes it's announced Krishna's gone to Chandravali. He's there with Chandravali. He's not.You know, and then Radharani feels, he's gone to another gopi, he's not with me.
那有的时候呢，比如说 Krishna 他会去找 Chandravali， 那然后就会让 Srimati Rarin 在想，哦，他去找别的 Gopi 了，他又不来找我。
So it increases the pleasure in their loving exchange.
这样的话呢，就会使他们之间爱的这种互动和交流呢，就变得更加的炽烈，变得更加的加深。
Is there another question?
Yes, another question is, 对不起，我忘了这位，这个是从哪位奉献者那里的问题了，因为昨天忘了写这个奉献者的名字。这问题是这样的，请问
下面这个才是数不掉也跑不问的，就你现在念这个是数不掉也跑不问的。
OK， 那刚才那个问题是另外一位奉献者问的。那么现在这个问题是 Subhuti Roy Prabhu 的问题，请问 Maharaj， 在Ramananda Roy 给主 Chaitanya 的教导中给我们的启示是什么呢？之前主 Chaitanya 教导库马尔婆罗门留在家中，而这里说到牧牛姑娘为了服务 Krishna 离开了家，我们应该追随哪一个呢？Maharaj， my question is that from the teaching in between of Ramananda Roy and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what's the revelation to us? Because in Kumara Brahmana's teaching, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked him to stay at home and become a spiritual master to teach and to preach. However, here, for the gopis, because they want to render the service to the Lord, so they left their home. It seems that these two are, you know, two opposite instructions. So who are the right one we need to follow? Which are the right one we need to follow?
Yes, okay, so we have to understand that the gopis are very special devotees, and when they go to the pastimes of Krishna, they go in their spiritual bodies. They don't go in their material bodies. They go in their spiritual bodies.
那我们首先要明白，这个 Gopi 姑娘们，她们是非常特别的奉献者。当她们在进入到 Sri Krishna 的消时光中的时候呢，她们是以她们的灵性的躯体在进行这些活动的，并不是在她们的物质的躯体中去进行的。
Allah Krishna called them to come and dance. He didn't tell them not to go home. Of course, they went back. They went to the, they stayed in Vrindavan. They didn't leave home. They didn't just come with and go everywhere with Krishna and follow Krishna everywhere. They stayed there in Vrindavan.
当主 Krishna 把他们唤来并且让他们回家的时候，他们其实就是回家了。他们并没有在，他们依然还是住在 Vrindavan。他们并没有跟着 Sri Krishna 到处跑，跟着他。Krishna 去哪儿他就去哪儿。
And there's another pastime which comes in the 10th canto, where the wives of the brahmanas, there was the yagna patnis, that there were some brahmanas doing a ritualistic yagya, and their wives came to see Krishna and Balaram, and they wanted to stay with Krishna and Balaram, but Krishna told them, no, you go home, your husbands will take you, go back.
然后在圣典波迦瓦腾第十篇里面还有另外一段逍遥时光，那么这逍遥时光呢就讲的是这些婆罗门的妻子们，这个 Yagna Patnas 就是他们在这个他们的这个婆罗门丈夫在进行这些祭祀的活动的时候，这些婆罗门的妻子们跑来见 Krishna， 并且呢希望能够和 Krishna 在一起，然后 Krishna 就对他们说，不行，你们得回家去，然后你们的丈夫呢会继续照顾你们，所以你们不能够和我们在一起，所以呢，他们就回家了。
So Krishna calls the gopis when he plays the flute. He calls the gopis to come and dance Rasa Lila. They go in their spiritual bodies. They don't go in with material body.
所以说呢，当 Krishna 呼唤这些 gopi 们来和他进行 Rasa 之舞的这个逍遥时光的时候，gopi 们他们是以他们的灵性的躯体前来的，并不是以他们的物质的躯体来和 Krishna 跳舞的。
And they remain in Vrindavan. They remain there with their families.
而且呢，这些 gopi 们他们是留在了 Vrindavan 和他们的家人在一起。
But Krishna also stays in Vrindavan. He said Krishna is in the heart. He hides himself in the hearts of all the gopis.
但是呢 ，Sri Krishna 他也留在了 Vrindavan。 据说呢 ，Krishna 他藏在了所有的 Gopi 们的心里。
Yeah, Shamsundar Krishna is the form of Krishna who is performing the pastimes with the gopis. Shamsundar Krishna stays in Vrindavan.
和 Gopi 们上演消时光的这位 Krishna， 他的这个形象呢是 Shamsundar Krishna， 那是留在 Vrindavan 的这位 Krishna 也是 Shamsundar Krishna。
And Vasudev Krishna, he is the one who's killing the demons, and he goes to Mathura and then goes to Dwarka and marries all the queens. That's Vasudev Krishna.
而Vasudev Krishna 是那位去到 Mathura， 而且也是那位杀死了所有的这些恶魔，然后呢，后来又去到了 Dwarka 和 Dwarka 的所有的这些皇后们结婚的那位 Krishna。
So Vasudev Krishna is the form of Krishna from the, that is Krishna in Vaikuntha, but Shamsundar Krishna is Krishna in Goloka.
而Vasudev Krishna 他是来自于 Vaikuntha 的 Krishna 的形象，而Shamsundar Krishna 呢是来自于 Goloka 的 Krishna。
Okay, so we say for all the gopis, there's no desire of sense gratification. They only want to give pleasure to Krishna.
所以说呢，对于所有的这些 gopi 们，他们是没有任何的感官享乐的欲望的。他们唯一想要做的事情就是要让 Krishna 开心。
And when they are playing with Krishna, performing, dancing with Krishna, walking with Krishna, it's all done, everything is for Krishna's pleasure.
所以说呢，当他们在和 Krishna 在跳舞的时候，或者说在和 Krishna 在上演各种各样的活动的时候，无论和 Krishna 所从事的任何的活动，全部都是为了让 Krishna 高兴。
In the Gopi Gita, there's a nice verse that describes how the gopis pray to Krishna.
在 Gopi Gita 里面有一首非常动听的诗节，这里面就描述了 Krishna 如何，这些 Gopi 们如何向 Krishna 祈祷。
Yate sajata charanam buruham staneshu budva shane priyadadi mahikarkakeshu tena tavam atasitad vyatatena kimsvitKorpa dibir brahmati dir bhavadaya shamna. The gopis are worried about Krishna being in the forest, that his feet are very soft and there's many stones and thorns and his soft feet will be in pain.
Gopi 们非常的担心在森林中的Krishna, 因为呢他的莲花足是如此的柔软稚嫩。而在这个地方，在这森林里面呢，有很多的荆棘，有很多的碎石，有很多的这个扎脚的这个沙粒，所以一定会伤着他的柔软的莲花足的。
And if Krishna's feet are feeling pain, then the gopis are feeling also pain. That oh, this is not good. The gopis are worried about Krishna.
所以，如果是 Krishna 他要是感到疼的话，那 gopi 们也会感到非常的心痛。所以这可不好，因为他们在内心中非常的为 Krishna 而担忧。
So you want to go to Goloka Vrindavan, you want to be with Krishna, you have to develop the mood of the gopis. It has to be that spontaneous love.
所以说，如果你要是想要去到 Goloka Vrindavan, 想和 Krishna 在一起的话，那就必须要培养出 gopi 们的这种心态，也就是对 Krishna 的非常自发的本真的爱。
The gopis don't know Krishna as God. They only know Krishna as the son of Nanda Maharaj.
Gopi 们他们并不知道 Krishna 是神，他们只知道 Krishna 是 Nanda 王的爱儿。
Now, if you only want to love Krishna because he's God, that's Vaikuntha. That's not Goloka Vrindavan.
但是如果你要是因为只是 Krishna 是神而想去爱他的话，那么这样的心态呢是在。
You, I hope you don't mind having a boyfriend who is a cowherd boy. I hope you don't mind, huh?
那我 我希望你不介意有一个作为牧牛童的男朋友。
You know, cowherd boys, you know, because they're with the cows all day, they always smell of cows. All their clothes smell of cows, you know, and they'll smell of cows. You know, and so you're going to be with them all the time, you'll smell the cows.
那因为这牧牛童呢，一整天都和牛在一块儿，所以呢，他这一身上都是这个牛身上的味道，他的衣服也都是牛身上的味道。所以如果你要是有一个牧牛童的男朋友的话呢，你自己这身上也会变成牛的味道了。
But remember, Krishna's got a lot of cows.
而且我们也记得 ，Krishna 有好多好多的乳牛。
I don't know if Krishna smells of cows, but he's a cowherd boy.
但是我不知道 Krishna 他是不是身上也是这种牛的味道。但是 Krishna 他就是一个母牛童。
Sometimes we say the Krishna's body smells like kasturi. Kasturi is a very special aroma, special oil fragrance, and they say that's the aroma of Krishna's body.
那有的时候呢，我们知道 Krishna 他的这个身体所散发的这种芬芳呢，被称为叫 kasturi 的这种芬芳。那这是一种很特别的一种香氛的味道。
Now, an interesting example was given about the personified Vedas. The personified Vedas also wanted to develop love like the gopis.
那有这么一个很有意思的例子，就是韦达金的人格化身，他也希望能够培养出 gopi 们对 Krishna 的这种爱恋的情怀。
So they had to also develop this mood of spontaneous love.
所以说呢，他也必须要培养出对 Krishna 的自发的爱的情感才行。
Now initially they couldn't do it.
但在最开始的时候呢，他做不到。
Because they were just trying to have the mood of the gopis, and just having the mood of the gopis wasn't enough to develop the same mood, the spontaneous attraction for Krishna.
因为呢，他们只是让自己试着处于 gopi 的心绪之中，但是呢，只是这种尝试的处于 Krishna 的这个 gopi 的心绪中是不够的，没有办法足够的让他去培养出对 Krishna 的自发的爱。
So what they did finally was they gave up their bodies and they took birth in the family of gopis, and they actually had gopi bodies. And in the body of a gopi, then they could become like the gopis.
那所以他们怎么办呢？他们最后只能够放弃自己现实的这个躯体，然后呢，重新的投生在 gopi 的家庭里，然后呢，让自己得到一具 gopi 的躯体，然后这样在 gopi 的躯体中才能够去培养出 gopi 们所具备的自发的爱的情怀。
It's not enough to just be a gopi in your mind. You have to give up your body and take birth in Braja and become a gopi.
所以说呢，在内心中只是有这种 gopi 的心态还不够，必须得先要放弃躯体，然后呢，在 Braja 投生，然后呢，重新得到一个 gopi 的躯体才可以。
Then we actually qualify to follow in the footsteps of the gopis.
这样我们才能够真正的具有追随 gopi 的莲花足迹的资格。
So the personified Vedas, they did like that. They took birth in the families of gopis, and they all became gopis, and they were able to take part in Krishna's Rasa Leela.
那对呢，就是这个韦达经的这些人格化身们，所以他们就这么做了。他们放弃了自己的躯体，并且呢，投生在 Braja 的 gopi 的家里面，并且呢，重新又得到了 gopi 的躯体，从而呢，他们就变成了 gopi， 然后呢，可以加入到 Krishna 的 Rasa Leela 的逍遥之中。
So just following regulative principles, that will get you to Vaikuntha.
对，如果我们要只是去遵循规范原则的话呢，那会把我们引向 Vaikuntha。
But if we want to get into Goloka Vrindavan, we have to develop love for the son of Nanda Maharaj.
但是如果我们要想去到 Goloka Vrindavan 的话呢，我们就必须要培养出对 Nanda 王的爱儿的这种爱恋之情。
We don't get Krishna just by doing austerities or just by being a great scholar.
为了我们不仅仅是通过我们的这个苦行，或者说是这个学到很多的这种学问 然后培养出这样对 Krishna 的爱。
We have to develop the mood of the gopis.
对的，我们必须要培养出 gopi 们的心态。
And that means to think about the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
那也就意味着我们总要去冥想着 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
So then after thinking about Radha and Krishna for a long time, and getting free from material contamination, then can go to the spiritual world.
对呢，当我们冥想 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光很长时间之后，然后并且呢，就是清除掉了我们物质的这些污染之后，然后我们才可以进入到灵性的世界去。
And then in the spiritual world, we had a chance to serve Radha and Krishna as a gopi.
那然后在灵性世界呢，我们就有一个机会能够作为 gopi 来服务 Radha 和 Krishna。
But if we are attached to knowledge, we are attracted by the opulence of the Lord, then we cannot get the shelter, the real shelter of the Lord's lotus feet.
但是如果我们要是只是依附于这些知识，然后呢，只是 sorry, if we only attached to the Lord's knowledge and the
knowledge of the Lord's opulence.
Okay, 那就如果我们要是只是依附于这个主的知识，而且呢，就只是去依附于非常被主的这些富裕所吸引的话，那我们其实没有办法真正的进入到这个文达们的这个苍穹，是和主 Krishna 去培养出这种爱的这种关系的。
And we see the example of the goddess of fortune.
那我们这个呢，已经从幸运女神的例子里面能够看到了。
She worshipped Krishna to join his pastimes in Vrindavan.
那她呢，是通过崇拜 Krishna， 希望能够加入到 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光中。
But she has an opulent lifestyle.
但是呢，她过着非常富裕的生活。
So she could not get the service of Krishna in Vrindavan.
所以呢，她就没有办法得到在 Vrindavan 对 Krishna 的服务。
So even beautiful women in the material world, they don't get to dance with Krishna and Rasalila.
所以说呢，在这物质世界的美丽的女子也没有办法得到在 Rasalila 中和 Krishna 一同跳舞的机会。
Even the beautiful women from the heavenly planets don't get that pleasure.
那么，即便是在天堂星宿的这些美丽女子们，她们也没有办法得到这样的殊荣。
So when Ramananda Rai was explaining all this to Lord Chaitanya, they embraced each other and they both began to cry.
那么，所以当 Ramananda Rai 他向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 解释做这一切的时候呢？他们俩人就相拥在了一起，并且哭泣了起来。
They spent the whole night together talking about Krishna. In the morning, they went back to do their duties.
那他一整夜都在探讨关于 Radha 和 Krishna 的话题，然后第二天清晨呢，他们又去做自己需要履行的职责。
So, Lord Chaitanya, he wants to go to South India, but before he leaves,Ramananda Rai comes and he falls at the feet of Lord Chaitanya. And he begs Lord Chaitanya. He said, please stay here for at least 10 days and purify my mind.
然后呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他希望继续去南印度了。那么在他离开之前呢， Ramananda Rai 来顶拜 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。那 Ramananda Rai 请求 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，你能不能在这再多待十天，从而呢能够帮我净化我的内心。
But Lord Chaitanya said, I have come to hear about Krishna from you and purify my mind.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我是来这儿来听你讲述的，从而能够净化我的心意。
So now I know your glories. I what everybody told me about you, it's all confirmed.
而现在呢，我明白了你的荣耀，而且呢，所有的人都说了，就像我说了你的荣耀，可是现在呢，被我所证实了。
Lord Chaitanya said, "Why should I only just stay 10 days? I want that we should always be together."
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，为什么我只在这待十天呢？我希望我们两人能永远在一起。
You come to Jagannath Puri and we will stay together and we will talk about Krishna and his pastimes.
你呢来到 Jagannath Puri, 然后我们能一起来共同探讨 Sri Krishna 的逍遥时光。
So Lord Chaitanya stays more days there and every day they would have questions and answers. This is how they would discuss devotional service. Lord Chaitanya would put questions and Ramananda Roy would answer.
所以呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢又在这儿多待了度日，然后每天呢他们都会以一问一答的形式来进行探讨。那么这个呢也就是对奉爱服务进行探讨的过程。那么Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢每次都会提出问题，而 Ramananda Roy 呢会回答问题。
Very interesting questions.
都是非常有意思的问题。
Lord Chaitanya asked Ramananda Roy, of all types of education, which is the most important?
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 询问 Ramananda Roy, 在所有各种各样的教育之中，哪一种教育最重要？
Right.So, who knows the answer?
所以，请问哪位奉献者知道答案是什么？
What's the most important education?
最重要的教育是什么？
Sati, Tai Tai.
Sati Maji. Sati, Sati Maji is not here.
Oh, who's there?
Lisa? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 是不是奉爱服务的知识或者超然的知识是最重要的知识？
Yeah, right. Yes, transcendental devotional service to Krishna. That's real education.
对 Krishna 的超然的知识是真正的教育。
Yeah, we want to hear about Krishna.
所以呢，我们希望能够听到关于 Krishna 的信息。
And then Lord Chaitanya asked,Of all different glorious activities, what is the most glorious?
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 又问了，在所有的这些无上荣耀的活动中，哪一个活动是最荣耀的、最光荣的？
And the answer is.
答案是。
That one should be a devotee. The one who is a devotee, that's the most glorious of all.
那么一个人呢，他应该让自己成为奉献者。当他成为奉献者之后呢，这就是在所有的活动中最荣耀的一件事了。
And then Lord Chaitanya said, "What is the greatest rich wealth? What is the great, you know, many?" Many capitalists have a lot of wealth and money. So what is the greatest wealth?
然后主持人参加马宝又问了，他说有很多的资本家呢，有很多的财富，那么最伟大的财富是什么？
The greatest wealth is?
最伟大的财富是？
Who wants the greatest wealth?
谁想要爱？
Zaishua, what Shama
Ai? Krishna the Ai.
Yeah, love for Radha and Krishna the Ai. Radha and Krishna the Ai. Love for Radha and Krishna. That's.
Radha for Krishna the Ai.
And what's the most painful thing?
最痛苦的是什么？
Separation from the devotee of Krishna.
是和 Krishna 的奉献者的分离。
That's the most unbearable separation, unbearable distress, unhappiness.
那么这是让人最不能忍受的痛苦。
So like this, Lord Chaitanya and Ramananda Roy, Lord Chaitanya was putting many questions.
那所以就这样的方式呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他在 向 Ramananda Roy 提出了很多问题。
What should be constantly remembered?
还有什么是需要恒常不断的被记住的事情？就是哪件事情是被需要被恒常不断的记住的？
We should always remember Krishna's holy name.
就是应该时刻的记住 Krishna 的圣名。
And when we meditate, what should we meditate on?
那么当我们在冥想的时候，我们应该冥想什么呢？
The lotus feet of Radha and Krishna.
我们要冥想 Radha 和 Krishna 的莲花足。
And where should we live when we give up?All other places, which place should we go and live?
那么当我们放弃了所有其他的地方的时候，我们应该在什么地方去生活呢？
We should go to Vrindavan.
我们应该去到 Vrindavan.
Stay where Krishna performed Rasa Lila.
我们应该去到那个地方，就是 Sri Krishna 他上演他的 Rasa Lila 逍遥的地方。
And what is the most worshipable object? What's the best of all worshipable objects? What the,
哪个是什么是最棒的、最值得崇拜的事物呢？物品？
The holy name of Radha and Krishna. In other words, the Maha Mantra, the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Radha 和 Krishna 的圣名，换句话说呢，就是我们的 Maha Mantra， Hare Krishna 的 Mantra。
So this is the how Lord Ramananda Rai, Lord Chaitanya passed their time hearing。
这就是，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Rai 他们在一起的时候如何共度他们的时光的方式。
Sometimes they would chant and dance, sometimes they would cry, they would spend the whole night together.
那有的时候呢，他们会唱诵，有的时候他们会一起跳舞，然后有的时候呢，他们会哭泣，他们一整晚都在一起。
And during the day they'd go and do their work, and then at night they'd come back and be together again.
然后在白天的时候呢，他们就各自去忙活自己的工作职责，然后到晚上的时候呢，他们又聚集在一起。
So Ramananda Rai wants to get Lord Chaitanya's approval.
那然后呢 ，Ramananda Rai 呢，希望得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的允许。
He said, you have instructed me in everything from the heart, just like Brahma got instruction from Krishna, you have spoken to my heart, through my heart.
他说呢，您呢，在我的内心中为我起亮了所有的这些讯示，那么就好像是主 Vishnu 他在内心中起亮了主 Brahma 一样，那么您呢，也在我的内心中告诉我所有的一切。
So Ramananda Rai said, I just have one doubt.He said, I have one doubt. He said, but first I saw you appear like a sannyasi.
But Ramananda Roy said, 我内心中只有一个困惑，就是因为首先呢，您是以 sannyasi 的形象展现的。
But now I see you like a cowherd boy, like Shamsundar, the cowherd boy.
而现在呢，我看见您就像是一个牧牛童一样，像 Shamsundar.
I see you.Like a golden doll, your body is covered with this golden luster.
而且呢，我看到您好像是一束金色的光芒。 而且我也能够看到您的这个身体展现着金色的光晕。
And you have a flute in your mouth. You're holding a flute.
在您的这个唇边呢，还架着一支笛子。您用手托着笛子在唇边吹。
So Ramananda Rai says to Lord Chaitanya, I keep seeing you in this way. So can you tell me what is causing this? Why is it like this?
对 Ramananda Rai 说呢，因为我不断的看见您所展现给我的是这样的一个景象，所以您能不能告诉我是什么样的原因导致我看到这样的景象呢？
So Lord Chaitanya told him, he said, because you have so much love for Krishna,So one who has such love for Krishna, they see Krishna everywhere.
然后主持人妈妈说呢，就是因为对 Krishna 有这么深的爱，当一个人对 Krishna 有很深的爱的时候，他就无处不在的能够见到 Krishna.
This is like the Mahabhagavat devotee, like Prahlad Maharaj, everywhere they see Krishna.
那么就像是一位 Mahabhagavat 的奉献者，比如像 Prahlad Maharaj.他无处不在的能够见到 Krishna.
Right, Haranyakashipu is asking Prahlad Maharaj, "Where is your God? You say he's everywhere. He's in here." And Prahlad said, "Yeah, he's here."
Haranyakashipu 问 Prahlad Maharaj 说：“你的神在哪儿啊？你的神难道就在这儿吗？你因为无处不在能够见到他。”然后 Prahlad Maharaj 说：“对呀，他就在这儿。”
And this way, Lord Nrisingadeva appeared to Haranyakashipu.
然后就以这样的方式呢，主女心看的就显现在了黑人和须布的面前。
So Lord Chaitanya is explaining to Ramananda Rai that you know this is due to your love of Krishna that you're seeing Krishna everything and you're seeing Krishna everywhere.
那所以呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就向 Ramananda Rai 解释说呢，这全部都是源自于你对 Krishna 的爱。所以呢，使得你在无处不在的能够见到 Sri Krishna。
Because you're an advanced devotee, you have natural love for Radha and Krishna. Therefore, whatever you see, it awakens your Krishna consciousness.
那么，因为呢，你对于 Radha 和 Krishna 有这种非常这个本真的爱，所以呢，你也就很自然的能够在无处不在的见到 Radha 和 Krishna， 而且呢，你所看到的一切都能够唤醒你的 Krishna 知觉。
But Ramananda Rai says to Lord Chaitanya, I said, do not conceal your real form from me. Stop speaking all of this philosophy to me.
然后呢 Ramananda Rai 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，请你不要把你真正的形象从我的眼前藏起来，请你不要再跟我讲这些哲学了。
I can understand that you have assumed the ecstasy and the thin complexion as Radharani.
那我能够看出来，其实你是展现了Radharani 的极乐以及她的肤色。
And that's why you have appeared as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那也就是因为这个原因，所以为什么你会展现为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的形象？
You want to taste the spiritual bliss of which Radharani experiences.
那你呢是希望能够去品尝 Srimati Radharani 所体验的灵性的极乐。
And at the same time, you're spreading love of God.
与此同时呢，你又在传播着神爱。
And somehow you have appeared before me to benefit me, to give me liberation.
但无论如何呢，您显现在我的面前。为的是让我获益，从而让我能够得到解救。
Ramananda Rai says, Krishna is the reservoir of pleasure.
Ramananda Rai 说呢 ，Krishna 是一切的快乐的蓄水池。
And Radharani is the form of love of God.
而 Radharani 呢是对爱是对神爱的。是一种神爱的形象的展现。
And these two have become one in your form as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
而这两点呢，成为了就是在你的 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的形象中展现为了一体。
So at that time, Lord Chaitanya appeared as Radha and Krishna to Ramananda Rai.
所以呢，就在这一刻的时候呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就以 Radha 和 Krishna 的形象显现在了 Ramananda Roy 的面前。
Right, we say Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya。
那我们说 Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Ahi Ranya。
Radha Krishna。
Radha Krishna。
Nahi Anya。
Nahi Anya.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya.
Anya.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya.
Anya.
Yeah, right. Meaning?Lord Chaitanya is not different from Radha and Krishna.
刚才这块的意思呢，就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 与 Radha 和 Krishna 没有区别。
And Lord Chaitanya showed this to Ramananda Roy.
而 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，把这就显现给了 Ramananda Roy.
The two, Lord Chaitanya is there, and then he saw also Radha and Krishna came. They both came from the body of Lord Chaitanya.
所以他丹娘妈后在那里，但是呢，他又同时是在这个躯体里面显现了 Radha 和 Krishna。
So Ramananda Roy, when he saw Radha and Krishna, then he fell on the ground unconscious.
所以呢，当 Ramananda Roy 看到了 Radha 和 Krishna 的形象的时候呢，他倒在了地上，失去了知觉。
But Lord Chaitanya took his hand and immediately became conscious.
但是呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 抓起了他的手，他立刻又恢复了他的知觉。
And then he saw Lord Chaitanya as a sannyasi.
然后呢，他这会儿看到的是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的 sannyasi 的形象。
And Lord Chaitanya told him, "No one has ever seen this form before. You're the only one."
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对他说呢，在之前从来没有任何一个人看见过这个形象，你是唯一见到这个形象的人。
Lord Chaitanya told me, "You know everything, so I've shown this form to you."
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，因为你是了解所有这一切的，所以我才会把这个形象显现给你看。
Lord Chaitanya said, "Actually, he said my body doesn't have a fair complexion."
嗯，然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，其实我的这个躯体它其实并没有一个白皙的皮肤。
But it appears like this because I've touched the body of Radharani.
嗯、但是它显现出这样肤色的原因的原因是因为我触碰了 Radharani 的这个躯体。
But she does not touch anyone except for the son of Nanda Maharaj.、
嗯、但是呢 Srimati Radharani 她除了碰过 Nanda 王的儿子之外她其实谁都没有碰过。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "I've changed my body into the ecstasy of Radharani."
那所以说呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，我就把我的这个躯体更换在了Sri Mati Radharani 的极乐之中。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya revealed his identity to Ramananda Roy.
所以呢，用这样的方式，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu把他的这个身份揭示给了Ramananda Roy.
So Lord Chaitanya told Ramananda Roy, "Don't tell anyone about this. Keep this all confidential."
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Ramananda Roy 说呢，不要把这件事情跟任何人去讲，你一定要把它作为一个很高的机密把它藏起来。
Lord Chaitanya said, "I'm just like a madman, and you're also a madman."
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说
"We're on the same platform."
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我呢就是一个疯子，而你呢也就像是一个疯子，所以咱俩呢是处在一个层面上的。
Just like devotees, you know, people often say about devotees, "You people are crazy, you're mad."
那就好像是奉献者，有些人在说奉献者的时候呢，就说这些人是疯子，他们就是疯了。
Though they said the same about Lord Chaitanya, Ramananda Roy.
所以呢，他们也是同样的这样的方式去讲是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Roy 的。
They're the most exalted persons, and people thought they're crazy.
但是他们其实是最崇高的人物，但是人们却觉得他们是疯子。
Okay, any questions?
Yes, Maharaj, here is a question.
福州的苏尼提马太吉有一个问题。
哦、好吧。
苏尼提马太吉，你注意听了、啊。 Guru 回答你的问题。请问 Guru， 请在什么时候展示出来的哭泣是灵性的哭泣？
Suniti Maharaj's question is that, when the cry, the weeping, is considered as the spiritual weeping?
When we cry?
Yeah. So when the cry is considered as the spiritual cry.
When is it considered spiritual? Well, when we're crying for Krishna, that's spiritual.
那么当我们为 Krishna 而哭泣的时候，这个哭泣就是灵性的哭泣。
And if you're crying because of your lack of Krishna consciousness, that's also very good.
那如果我们要是因为觉得自己缺少 Krishna 知觉而哭泣的话，这个哭泣也很好。
We want to develop more Krishna consciousness. We feel ourselves very unfortunate.
那如果我们要是希望能够培养出更多的 Krishna 知觉，觉得自己是非常的不幸的话，这样的哭泣是好的。
That we're not able to progress in Krishna consciousness.
那我们觉得自己缺少 Krishna 知觉，可是在 Krishna 知觉中呢，也没有办法取得进步。
That we want Krishna consciousness very badly and we can't get it, we should cry.
如果我们要是特别想要得到 Krishna 知觉，可是又得不到的话，这会儿我们就应该哭。
So are you crying for is your crying spiritual?
所以说 Suniti Maharaj 你是在为了这个灵性的事而哭吗？
If you're crying that, oh, I don't have food, I don't have money, I don't have anybody to love me, then that's material.
那现在如果要是为了我没有钱，我没有吃的，或者没有人爱我，为这事而哭的话，那这就是物质的哭。
But Krishna loves everyone.
但是 Krishna 爱所有的人。
But we're not taking care of Krishna. We're neglecting Krishna.
但是我们并没有很好的照顾 Krishna， 我们把他给忽略了。
So we should cry. That I'm so fallen. I'm so stupid. I've neglected. I've wasted my life.
那么所以呢，我们应该为了我是如此的愚蠢，如此的堕落。
Just like somebody who knowingly drinks poison.
就比如说有些人呢，他是明知道是毒，他还要去喝这个毒药。
So, yeah, very unfortunate. We should cry.
那所以说呢，我们非常的不幸，所以我们应该哭。
Very unfortunate that we wasted our human life and we didn't develop love for Krishna.
那我们非常的不幸，因为我们在浪费我们人类的躯体，我们并没有去培养对 Krishna 的爱。
Is it clear, Suniti?
Suniti Maharaj, 这样清晰吗？
Suniti 还是 Suruchi？She went.
Suniti.
Suniti. Suniti.
Suniti. Suniti Mama. 明白吗？
她不在这个房间，她在企业直播，企业微信直播里面在看。
Okay. Suniti Maharaj, she is not in this chat room. She is hearing the lecture from another channel. So she's not able to answer your question directly. Has to still join a couple of books. 那庞峰，您那边还有问题吗？因为这边还有个问题。
好，你在念这边的，那边没有了。
Okay. 那 Marge, here is the question from Puspa Sara Mataji. 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜所有的奉献者，请问 Guru Maharaj, Vishnu 和 Krishna 的关系是什么？ Please accept my humble obeisances to you and to all the devotees. My question is that how the Lord Vishnu and Krishna related to each other?
We're going to hear more about that when we go to Sri Rangam, because in Sri Rangam, the devotees there are from the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, which comes from Ramanuja.
那我们去到 Sri Rangam 的时候呢，会就这个话题聆听更多的信息。因为呢，在 Sri Ranga 那儿的奉献者呢，他们是来自于Sri Sampradaya。那这 Sri Sampradaya 呢，是由 Sri Ramanuja 所创办的传系。
But generally we say, Vishnu and Krishna are the same.
那总体来说呢，我们说 Vishnu 和 Krishna 他们是没有区别的。
Vishnu is the opulent form, and Krishna is playful.
那 Vishnu 呢是一个富裕的形象，而 Krishna 呢是好玩的形象。
Krishna enjoys playing with all the devotees.
因为 Krishna 呢，他非常的享受和所有的这些奉献者们一起玩耍。
So there are four special opulences which are found in Krishna, which are not in Vishnu.
那么在 Krishna 身上呢，能够发现有四种富裕。那这种富裕，这四种富裕呢，在 Vishnu 身上是没有的。
One is Krishna's flute playing attracts people all over the universe.
那么其中一点呢，是 Sri Krishna 他的笛音，他能够吸引在宇宙中的所有的生物体。
The second thing is Krishna is always with his devotees.
那么第二点呢，是 Sri Krishna 永远都是和他的奉献者在一起。
The third thing is he performs very wonderful pastimes.
然后呢，他会去这第三点呢，就是他会上演非常美妙的逍遥时光。
And the fourth thing is his very, very exquisite beauty.
而且呢，这第三点呢，这第四点呢，就是 Krishna 他具有非常非常精致的美。
Now Vishnu is also beautiful, but Krishna has a special beauty because Krishna's in the mood of Vrindavan.
那 Vishnu 也很美，但是呢 ，Krishna 就特别的美，因为 Krishna 他是处在 Vrindavan 的心绪之中的。
Vishnu is more opulent.
那 Vishnu 呢，他具有更多的富裕。
And the opulence creates a distance between Vishnu and the devotees.
但是就是因为他这个富裕呢，使得 Vishnu 和奉献者之间有拉开了距离。
But Krishna's in Vrindavan, he's from the cowherd boy, he's got a peacock feather in his hair and a garland of forest flowers. Krishna's very, very simple, natural.
但是呢，在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 呢，他会带着孔雀羽毛，然后呢，会带着由森林的鲜花所穿着的花环。所以呢，在 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 呢，它展现出来的是很简单，而且呢也很自然的一种状态。
That you can easily approach Krishna, and everything is very pleasing and sweet. Not like with Vishnu, where it's Vaikuntha and it's very opulent.
好，那然后呢，就是去取悦 Krishna 的时候呢，所有的一切都非常的甜美。它不像在 Vaikuntha 的 Vishnu 那。在 Vaikuntha 的 Vishnu 所展现的呢，是非常的富裕，有非常的堂皇、富丽堂皇的那种状态。
We are speaking also on the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita every Tuesday morning. We speak on the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, and we tell about Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan.
嗯，那我们每周二早晨呢，也会讲述Brihad Bhagavat Amrita。Brihad Bhagavatamrita 就是大波迦瓦谈甘露之羊。那么在这里面呢，我们讲述的是 Gopal Kumar 的故事。那他就是来自 Vrindavan 的一个牧牛童。
And we hear when he went to Vaikuntha, how everything has to be exactly according to the rules and regulations.
那然后我们就听到，当他来到Vaikuntha的时候呢，他就发现，在 Vaikuntha 做的一切都必须要守规矩。
And you can't get too close to Lord Vishnu.
而且呢，你也不可能特别的接近主 Vishnu.
Gop Kumar, he always wants to run forward and embrace Lord Vishnu.
而 Gopal Kumar 呢，他总是想要跑到主 Vishnu 面前去拥抱他。
But the people of Vaikuntha, they would hold him back. They say, "No, no, you can't do that here."
那然后呢 ，Vaikuntha 的这个居民们呢，一下就会抓住他，然后呢，告诉他，不行不行，你在这儿不能这么干。
And so the rules and regulations are more prominent in Vaikuntha.
所以说呢，在 Vaikuntha 呢，那儿的规范和原则、规矩就更加的占主导地位。
Lord Vishnu is worshipped there in Vaikuntha.
那在那个地方呢，主 Vishnu 被崇拜着。
But in Goloka, Krishna is worshipped, and Krishna wants spontaneous love.
而在 Goloka Vrindavan 呢，崇拜的是 Krishna， 而 Krishna 他希望得到的是这种自发的本真的爱。
Okay. So.
Yeah. Yeah. The next question.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. The next question from.
好，你那边先说吧，这边也有一个问题。
我这边还有两个问题。Krishna Baladev, Balaram Prabhu, Chaitanya 和Ramananda Roy 在一起的时候为什么会哭泣呢？两个爬布在一起，他们出于什么而哭泣呢？When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Roy went out together, why they're crying with each other? Because they are two Prabhus. What's the reason to make them cry?
Well, they're crying in ecstasy of love of Krishna.
那他们是因为在对 Krishna 的极乐之爱中而哭泣。
Remember, Lord Chaitanya is in the mood of Radharani.
那大家要记得，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他是处在 Radharani 的心绪之中。
And we said Ramananda Roy is actually the Gopi Vishakha.
而 Ramananda Roy 呢，他其实是 Gopi Vishakha.
So in their spiritual bodies, they're in the mood of Gopis.
所以呢，在他们的灵性的躯体中，他们是处在 Gopi 的心绪之中的。
And so they're shedding tears. Their tears are of love. Their tears are. It's not pain. It's not.Suffering, but this is ecstasy, the tears of love.
对呢，他们在流泪，可是他们这个流泪呢，并不是痛苦的泪水，而是爱极乐的泪水，是为了爱而流出的泪。
When the tears are very hot, then these are the tears of passion. But when the tears are cool in water, that's the tears of pure love.
那么当我们的这个泪水是热的时候，那么这个泪水呢是在激情的情况下流下的泪。那么当我们的这个泪水它是凉的时候呢，那么这个就是在爱中所流下的泪水。
The
next question from Manini Radha Mataji, Dimbai Maharaj.给主 Gauranga 的神像戴孔雀羽毛会打扰主的心态吗？ Please accept my vulnerable obeisances. If we decorate the Lord Gauranga with the peacock feather, will that be the bothersome to the mood of the Lord?
Well, there are different opinions about this.
那关于这一点呢，有不同的说法。
Some people say.That Lord Chaitanya is in the mood of the devotee. So as a devotee of Krishna, he wouldn't wear the peacock feather.
那有些人说呢，因为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他是处在一个奉献者的心态下的。那么如果是作为 Sri Krishna 的奉献者的话呢，那他就不会戴孔雀羽毛。
But other people say, no, it's all right. Lord Chaitanya also revealed himself as the Supreme Lord.He sat on the throne in the home of Srivastakur. He sat on the throne of Vishnu and he revealed himself to all the devotees.
但是也有的奉献者就说呢，其实没关系，原因呢就是由于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他也把自己展现为至尊人格首身。他在 Srivastakur 的家里面的时候呢，把他至尊的这个身份向所有的奉献者展示了，而且呢，他也会坐在主 Vishnu 的皇座之上。
So Prabhupada never objected to us putting peacock feathers on Lord Chaitanya.
对，所以 Srila Prabhupada 呢，他从来就没有反对过为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 用孔雀羽毛来点缀。
So you can put peacock feathers on if you like.
所以如果你要是愿意的话呢，您可以给他用孔雀羽毛来装饰。
还有什么问题？
加拿大法部这边的问题没有了。
企业微信直播这边的主 party 这边倒是有问，感恩咕噜，是谁的话筒开了？请你关一下。这个13670的，好。
大家可以。
Hare Bhav. Hare
Bhav, Madhusudan Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. 听得到吗？
我能听见，现在能听见了，刚才听不见。
好，这边的卓帕迪马塔吉问：感恩咕噜，我们处在不同的阶段，那奉爱的心态也是不一样的。而对于 Ramanand Roy 跟主谈论勾匹和幸运女神不同的心态，是奉爱层面较高的阶段。目前我们是进化的阶段，就只想。如何具有 Krishna 知觉就好了，对吗？我们与主什么样的关系，自然还是不能，还是不能够理解，对吗？
Basically, she's asking that because right now we are still in the very, preliminary stage. Then at this point, to actually only think about how to obtain the Krishna consciousness will be alright, right?But Ramananda Roy and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are very exalted devotees, so that's why they are discussing about the very exalted topics about Sri Radha and Krishna. However, for us, we're only hearing about the topics, but we only think about that, how to obtain the Krishna consciousness. But at this point, we cannot really understand what's our relationship with Lord and Krishna, with Lord Krishna. Is that right?
Well, there's no harm for everyone to hear about Radha and Krishna and their pastimes if we hear it properly, if we hear it explained properly.
那如果我们要是从恰当的途径，并且以这个恰当的这种方式去聆听 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光的话，对于每个人来说都是没有任何的坏处的。
Srila Prabhupada released the Krishna book. He published the Krishna book in the very beginning of the Krishna consciousness movement.
在我们 Krishna 知觉很早期的时候呢 ，Srila Prabhupada 就发行了 Krishna 快乐源泉这本书。
Now in the Krishna book, it's a summary study of the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, and we get the pastime of Rasa Lila.
而这个Krishna 快乐源泉呢，它是 Krishna 快乐是这个圣典不加瓦坛第十篇的一个概要的内容，而这里面呢也讲述了关于 Rasa Lila 的逍遥时光。
And Srila Prabhupada used to speak on Chaitanya Charitamrita at the very beginning of the movement in 1966.
而且呢，在我们的运动的早期，在1966年的时候呢，Srila Prabhupada 就开始在讲述 Chaitanya Charitamrita 中的内容了。
So there's no harm for us to hear. We should develop a taste to try to understand pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
那么所以说呢，对我们来说呢，去聆听 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光呢是没有任何的坏处的。而且呢，我们也需要通过去聆听 Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光来让我们提升我们的品味。
We're only hearing in a very brief manner. I'm only giving you some of the basic points from the topics they discussed.
但是呢，我们只是非常的表面的简单的去了解这个话题，而且我现在呢也是只是把他们的这个对话中的非常的浅显的这个内容传递给大家。
Okay, any other question?
帕布还有别的问题吗？
不了，这边没有了。
还是最后呢，我可以提一个问题吗
？Okay, 可以啊。
咕噜，你刚才讲到了，只要是 Chaitanya Radha Krishna， 阿黑安塔，就是说福狗朗嘎和福 Krishna Radha Krishna 是一样的，但是因为我们现在服务的都是Gaurani Thai的神像，但是我们要恢复呢，却是对Radha 和 Krishna 的爱。那我们在临终的时候。要去冥想 Radha Krishna 的莲花组，就是那我们到底是想着 Gauranga 就可以呢，还是冥想圣名就可以呢，还是去冥想 Radha Krishna 的莲花组，或者是冥想 Radha Rani 就可以？
Because right now we are doing the service to Gaurani Thai. However, we really want to restore our love to Sri Radha and Krishna. So my question is that. for the last moment while we're leaving our body, who actually is the object we need to meditate on? Shall we meditate on Lord Gauranga or Sri Radha Krishna's lotus feet or Sri Krishna's lotus feet or only Sri Mati Rarani's lotus feet?
Well, it's up to you which particular deity you have developed the mood of loving devotion. Generally, generally we will worship Gaur Nitai, Lord Chaitanya, because he's very merciful.
那这其实完全取决于您在您所崇拜的这个神像中，您会对哪一尊神像培养出一种特别的这种情感？ 那么通常来说呢，我们是崇拜的高尔尼泰朱切丹尼亚马哈巴布的神像，因为他是非常的仁慈的。
Lord Chaitanya is the Kali Yuga avatar, and he's come to give Krishna consciousness to everyone.
所以切丹尼亚马哈巴布他是 Yuga avatar， 他是这个年代的化身，而他的前来呢是要把 Krishna 知觉给所有的人。
And if Lord Chaitanya wants, he can direct us to serve Radha and Krishna.
如果要是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu要是愿意的话呢，他就可以把我们引向对 Radha 和 Krishna 的服务之中。
Srila Prabhupada says, people in Vrindavan, they all seek the blessings of Radharani.
那Srila Prabhupada说呢，在Vrindavan的人们呢，他们总是在寻求着Srimati Radharani的仁慈。
And Srimati Radharani can introduce us to Krishna.
因为Srimati Radharani他可以把我们介绍给Sri Krishna。
So we have to approach Lord Chaitanya, and we approach Lord Chaitanya through Lord Nityananda.
那所以说呢，我们要接近朱柴坦尼亚，但是呢，我们要通过接近Sri Nityananda来接近Sri Chaitanya。
Lord Nityananda is the representative of the spiritual master. He's the original spiritual master.
而Sri Nityananda Prabhu呢，他是最原初的灵性导师，他是一切灵性导师的代表。
So we approach Lord Nityananda, and by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, we come to Lord Chaitanya.
那所以说呢，我们会接近朱尼天南的，然后在朱尼天南的仁慈之下呢，我们会来到朱尼天南的。
And Lord Chaitanya, he can take us to Radha and Krishna.
然后呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢会把我们带向Sri Radha和Krishna。
So we're quite satisfied to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya with the Sankirtan movement. The chanting of the holy name.
那么所以说呢，我们通过Sankirtan的运动，通过唱诵圣名的这个运动，我们就很心满意足的能够得到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的这种仁慈了。
So we want to meditate on the holy name at the time of leaving the body.
所以说，当我们在离开躯体的时候，我们希望冥想的是圣名。And
that holy name is given to us by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
而这圣名呢，就是集着Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的仁慈赐给我们的。 Maharaj, here's one more question here.
Yeah.
From Manini Radha Mataji. Maharaj, 您提到最难以忍受的是与奉献者的分离。当大家信赖的年长奉献者离开一个地方的时候，而新奉献者还不是很成熟的时候，我们应该如何应对这样的情况？ Maharaj, you mentioned that the most intolerable situation is the separation with the devotee. When the senior devotee left one place to another place, the new devotee, and also for the new devotee in this area, not very well developed yet, how can we, handle that kind of situation?
We have to handle that situation by taking shelter of the instructions of the senior devotees.
那么我们应对这样的情况的方法就是，让自己脱离在这位年长的奉献者的训示之中。
the senior devotees who are initially there, they give instructions and they set the standards and they tell you what we want to do. So they set up a situation, you want to continue, you want to follow their example, follow the program which they establish and keep it going.
那所以呢，他呢会确立一些这个活动的这些细则。那我们应该做的事情呢，就是去追随他的这个标准，然后呢继续做就好了。
And we associate by the physical presence is not eternal, but we associate by instruction.
且呢，就是我们所联谊的这个物质的这个，就是我们和物质的这个躯体进行那种亲身的联谊，它并不是一个永恒存在的状态。所以呢，我们真正联谊的那种状态呢，是和它的瞬时的联谊。
That's why we read Prabhupada's books. We feel connection to Srila Prabhupada by reading his books and by remembering his teachings.
这就是为什么我们要阅读Srila Prabhupada的书籍。那么，通过阅读Srila Prabhupada的书籍，我们能够感受到Srila Prabhupada的临在。然后我们通过这样的方式能够记住Srila Prabhupada所给我们的教导。
Okay, is that all right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Any other question there?
Not in this list here.
So okay, so we'll.
Guru Maharaj, 我有问题可以请教吗？
快一点。
快点。麻烦你说我妈的
顶拜咕噜马哈拉加顶拜大家就是刚刚讲那个马哈维斯鲁不是孩子被偷走当时啊那见到克西娜之后孩子有全部还给他们的妈妈吗
Is the Mahavishnu give back all of the children to theBrahma and his wife.
Yes.
After he take darshan to Vishnu, Krishna and Arjuna.
Yes, he brought them back to Dwarka.
是的，他们把所有的孩子都给带回到 Dwarka.
Because they were only in the abode of liberation, and Dwarka is better than the abode of liberation.
因为当时他们把这个孩子带的这个地方呢，是解脱之地。但是呢，杜瓦尔卡这个地方呢，要比解脱之地还要好。
杜瓦尔卡 is the holy dam, the Lord resides.
因为呢，这个杜瓦尔卡它是圣地，因为主是居住在这个地方。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna. 谢谢 Guru Maharaja, 谢谢。
谢谢。
孙姐姐。
Hare Krishna.Okay, Gaur Premanande Haribol, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai, Sayo De Fung Shianjir Ki Jai, Hare Krishna.